So if U.S. importer has a reason to believe, now we're still on a 30 calendar day rule. We're just going to clarify this a little bit more. If U.S. importer has a reason to believe that certificate of origin on which a declaration was based contains an information that is not correct, importer must make a corrected declaration, submit a letter or other written statement to the office where original declaration was filed. You see that 30 calendar rule again, and pay any duties that may be due. So if no duties are due, you don't have to pay, but corrected declaration must be made. Now let's see how it plays out in the context of the exam. So here we have a fact pattern, which says the following: a Canadian hockey equipment issues a NAFTA certificate of origin of shipment to hockey sticks to U.S. customer Hockey Sticks Incorporated. So you have two entities here. Apparently, the Canadian hockey equipment is based in Canada. Canadian hockey equipment. So that's Canada. And then you have Hockey Sticks Incorporated. And this is based in the United States. Canadian hockey equipment discovers that the sticks, so you have an exporter discovering at this point that the sticks do not qualify for NAFTA and provides written statements to Hockey Sticks Incorporated. So there is communication, right? And it's in writing. That's a red flag right there. Advising them of the mistake. In order to rectify the situation, CBP Hockey Sticks must also do which of the following? So let's take a look at the options that are provided by customs examiners. So number one, we're talking about the Hockey Sticks Incorporated, the U.S. side. Advise that CPB that Canadian hockey equipment owes them the duty due. As we learned from the importer of record part, payment of customs duties part, the ultimate responsibilities falls on the importer of record. The Canadian hockey equipment, they have the obligation under NAFTA to provide the certificate of origin and properly execute it. So they follow through their obligation. But the duty portion falls on the importer of record, in this case, Hockey Sticks Incorporated. So advice Canadian hockey equipment owes them duty due is really not the appropriate part, because if they did claim NAFTA duty preference in the at the time of declaration, then and it was incorrect, then they need to pay that duty amount, because otherwise they're depriving government of the revenue, plus they're submitting incorrect information, which can be subject to a whole bunch of penalties, including Section 163.6 penalties. We have 19 U.S.C. 1592 penalties. And if in the case of licensed customs broker, you have 19 U.S.C. 1641 penalties. So you have a whole laundry list. And there may be, if it's willful, there may be even criminal penalties attached, such as defrauding government of its revenue, section, I believe, 18 U.S.C. 1001, and mail fraud and wire fraud, for which people can go to prison. So you have that line of horribles that can happen. So, Canadian hockey equipment done its job. It is the Hockey Sticks Incorporated that must now go to customs and make that disclosure. So A is not correct. B, notify CBP and pay the duties due within 10 calendar days of having a reason to believe goods not qualify. This is incorrect because we have that 30 calendar day rule, remember? So the Hockey Sticks incorporated has 30 calendar days to make a correct declaration to customs. So B is incorrect for that reason. C, continue to file claims for NAFTA for Hockey Sticks. Well, if you do that, then you are defrauding customs of its revenue. So obviously that's not a good option. So C is not correct. NZ advised Canadian Hockey Equipment that they must notify CBP of the error and pay the duties due. No, this liability falls on the importer of record, in this case the Canadian the Hockey Sticks Incorporated. So D is wrong for that reason. E, notify CBP and pay the duties due within 30 calendar days. So we have the 30th calendar rule. Notify CBP the rule, which is a responsibility of the importer of record. And it must be the 30-day rule countdown starts from the day of making the discovery of the error. All right. So E fits the 30-day rule and fits the responsible party rule, which is the importer of record, which is Hockey Sticks Incorporated, making E a correct answer choice for this question.